Today, I'm going to showcase how the Wrike plugin works and looks like within Salesforce. Our first step here is to go into your Wrike account and go to the apps and integration page and search for Salesforce native integration. That's as easy as searching for Salesforce, and that's denoted with Wrike for Salesforce with our Wrike check logo here. Once you click on it, you're just going to click on install, and it'll take you through a sign-in process. You'll sign in through your Salesforce account and go through a small setup process to map out certain objects, but then the Wrike widget will be available to use in Salesforce. The second thing you need to do is add the Wrike widget to certain pages within Salesforce, and that's as easy as going into your object manager. I'm setting up the Wrike widget within our opportunities page. It's really as easy as adding a section here, going to that certain area of the page and adding that Wrike plugin. So for me, for example, I put it in the details page. I've added this Wrike widget here, just a small step there. Once you've done that, you can go to your opportunities page. My example here, I've got a Feather 1000 opportunity. It's already closed in one. I've got certain details of the opportunity as well. But at the bottom here, you can see that Wrike plugin. It's mapping to that project in Wrike itself. It's as easy as clicking on change folder and our project. You can certainly search for certain other different projects. If you want to switch, you certainly can. I'm in my Feather 1000. I see my structure here with all my folders and tasks and subtasks. We've got start dates, due dates, duration, status, and who it's assigned to. You can see that whole project structure here as well. Things do get updated in real time. So if a user is in Wrike and they say they add a new folder here. So for our example, I'm gonna add Feather 1000 and I'm gonna say it's 04 close. I can go ahead and go to my Salesforce account. I'm gonna refresh it real quick. Again, through the page layout, I've added it under my details tab. So I'm gonna click on my details tab here and I can see that close folder has shown up under here and I can simply just continue working. If I wanted to get into one of these folders or these tasks, it's as simple as clicking on it and it'll open a new Wrike tab. There's also a Wrike help section that we will or help page that gives a more detailed step-by-step instruction on how to install this and get this set up. But I wanted to just showcase at a high level what the plugin looks like within Salesforce. I do want to add that you are limited to making changes within Salesforce. This is really acts as a view-only look at your project structure within Wrike. Thanks for watching.